Hi friends, in today's video we're going to go over a common problem when buttons don't look in code the same as they do in design, specifically when they look wider or taller than intended, and if some buttons happen to have a border, that border will also make them look bigger compared to other buttons that don't have a border. So for example, I have my Figma design here, and I have a button that's supposed to have a minimum width of 80 pixels, a height of 40 pixels, and a horizontal padding of 16 pixels on each side. And then I have one button that has a solid fill, no border, and then I have another one that has a 2-pixel border. But then in code, even with the same properties, these buttons clearly do not look the same. And the answer to this problem is the CSS box sizing property. So in this video, we're first going to go over what box sizing property is and what are the possible values. And then we're going to go over two ways of implementing buttons and how the box sizing property affects each implementation. So we'll be talking about regular buttons and then link buttons. First, let's go over what box sizing property is. As it says right here, box sizing CSS property sets how the total width and height of an element is calculated. What this means is that it helps you decide whether or not you want the padding and the border to be included in the width that you set for your element or not. So for example, here we have a parent container, a child container, and these properties are applied to the child container. So right now we don't have any padding or border, and we have the width set to 100, so it just takes up the width of the parent container. But then when we have a border and a padding and still a width set to 100%, you can see that the child container is spilling out outside of its parent container. And the reason for that is because the value of the box sizing properties is set to content box, which means that padding and border are not going to be included in that 100% width. So additional pixels that come from the border and the padding are going to be added to the existing width. However, if we change the box sizing property to border box instead of content box, then the total width is going to include the border and the padding. And so this is why this child container is neatly nested inside the parent container. And so many people, including myself, find the border box to be a much more intuitive approach. But the problem is that by default, almost all HTML elements have the content box value, which means that you have to first know about the box sizing property and then also remember to add it to your CSS. And then the second part of this problem is that it feels like when many people learn CSS and frontend, this box sizing property just sort of gets skipped over, especially for people who are self-taught, again, myself included. And then we end up encountering these weird bugs or what we think are bugs, and we have no idea why it's happening. Now let's return back to our buttons and see how the box sizing property affects the button implementation. So something that many designers may not know is that there are two ways of implementing visually looking buttons in code. The first one is to use the actual button tag, and the second way is the link tag. And the reason that there are two ways is because the actual buttons are used for actions that trigger some JavaScript, for example, like opening up a model or submitting a form. But then if you wanted to use a button to go to a separate web page or to navigate within your app, you have to use the link tag instead. But from design perspective, we usually want to be able to style either button buttons or link buttons the same. We often want them to appear the same visually. So just for context, this is what the default button looks like. And this is what the default link looks like. So they start out with totally different styles. Now let's just talk about the regular buttons. So at the beginning of this video, I said that almost all HTML elements get content box sizing property by default. And content box property is the one that's not intuitive. Fortunately, buttons are one of those elements that get border box applied by default, which means that the border, the padding are going to be included in the width of the button, and that by default, the button implementation in code is going to match a Figma design. If for some reason your HTML button does not look as expected, it means that somewhere in the code base, you have a box sizing property set to content box. So if you have this problem, your or your developer's job is to find where that content box property is, understand why it's set there, and then make sure that it doesn't get applied to your buttons. It does not have to necessarily be set on the button element, element. It could be on the parent or maybe in the universal selector, which is denoted by this asterisk here. So it could be something like this. Again, if someone put it there, it's probably there for a reason, and that maybe some other elements or components need to have the content box sizing set. So definitely not saying that there's no use case for content box, but the fact that buttons are inheriting that behavior is most likely a bug. So you just need to make sure that it doesn't get applied to buttons. All right, so let's say you checked your code base and it doesn't say box sizing content box anywhere. What another problem could be is that you don't have a min width or height set on your buttons. So for example, let's comment this out. So now as you can see, my primary button is smaller than my secondary button because secondary has a border. So just remember, for the border box to have an effect on your buttons, you need to make sure to have the height and the width set. Let's make this like more realistic by adding vertical padding. So this is another potentially very confusing situation where you think, oh, maybe I have content box applied somewhere, but you can't find it. But the problem here is there is no height or min width set. And by the way, just for demonstration purposes, if you go inside DevTools and find the user agent style sheet, it's going to be in italics, and scroll down, you'll see that under box sizing, it says border box. This is how you can tell that the button by default is always going to have the intuitive border box value. All right, so hopefully if you had that issue with the HTML buttons, you have found your solution in this first half of the video. And now we're going to talk about the link buttons. So I'm going to comment out this bit here. And now we have our example with links. So here's the confusing part. Our regular HTML buttons get border box by default, which is what we want, it's intuitive, but our links don't get border box property by default. They get content box. Content box does not include border or padding. It just adds it to whatever is the set width or height is. And this could sound very frustrating, especially because once again, in many instances, we may want our styles for links and buttons to look visually the same. But the thing is, and I could be speculating here, is that initially, if we look at this default styles, people probably didn't assume that this could be the case of styling buttons and links the same. So by default style, you can see that the button, it has a border by default. So it made sense to give it the border box sizing model. But the link is just a text. It really was not meant to look as a button. So that's why it just gets the overarching content box. So you see, when I inspect it, I don't even have the box sizing in the default link styles. Anyway, to solve this problem, you want to make sure that your links get box sizing border box. But before I just added under our link styles over here, you probably also want that border box to be applied for most elements. For example, you might have cards and some cards have borders, some don't. And obviously you also want those to line up. And there could be tons of other components. So the best practice to do is to, returning back to our universal selector, is to add box sizing border box at the top of your style sheet. And just make that the default. And then if you want content box for some other elements, maybe it's best to apply those specifically to those elements. Anyway, so if you're doing visual QA and you see that some buttons look as expected and some buttons don't, maybe it's because some buttons are the actual buttons and then other buttons are links disguised as buttons. Okay, I know I always say it after all of my videos that I hope this video was helpful, but I really hope that this video in particular was truly helpful and that it really did not end up confusing you even more. I think in order to understand this concept, the best thing that you can do is to go and play and toggle on and off different box sizing properties, widths, heights, play with links, play with buttons. So I am going to leave this code pen in the description so you can just get straight to it. I'll also leave the link to the docs as I personally have also found this page to be very helpful. And if you found this video useful, please consider sharing it with your designer and developer friends. Lastly, if you did not get enough of buttons and CSS in this video, check out this video. It's a much lighter tutorial where you can learn how to create a fun icon animation. Thank you for watching and until next time. Bye-bye.